We'll get in another guest on the show. Anshu Kapoor of Edelweiss would be joining us very shortly as far as the show is concerned. In fact, any moment he'll be joining us. We are aiming at understanding how the affluent end of the industry doing right now in terms of investors. How are they approaching the market? Anshu Kapoor, of course, heads the premium or wealth end of the business. All right, Anshu Kapoor is right here with me. I can see him there working from home. Anshu, how is it panning out for you working from home? How has the business been affected, or has it been in the first place? Just like, you know, the business media adjusted pretty well working from home. How is it for you guys at Edelweiss?
Hi, Ajay. Good afternoon. Thank you for having me on the show. It's great to be with you. Yes, actually, it's been very seamless, Ajay, if I were to say. And thanks to all the investments in technology we were making over the last 4-5 years. And the way technology has evolved, it's actually quite possible for us now to work from home. And I mean, that's a realization for us also. We never thought that we could be so effective working from home. So yes, that's a good realization, and maybe points to the future as to how we will take things forward from here. Our business, you know, our clients are invested and they have needs on a daily basis to maybe transact or to take a view on the markets or to invest their surpluses. So our business is impacted, but not as much as we would see in other sectors. So I can tell you maybe our business volumes will be down about 15-20%, but that's about it. So we've been very effectively been able to service the client from home. In fact, our clients do as much as about 1% of traded volumes in cash equities every day. And we are able to seamlessly offer that service. So in that sense, very seamless, yes. A little impact, but given the nature of our business just doesn't go down to zero.
Right. Anshu, you know, you guys are working with some of the most affluent investors, be it individuals who run large portfolios across the country, some of the family office accounts I'm aware of. Talk to us about how are these guys approaching the markets right now. We are in the throes of a massive correction, one of the worst we've seen, and it did not come suddenly. We have already underperformed for last 18 months. So this COVID related hit actually broke the back of the camel. What kind of discussions you're having with your clients?
Right, Ajay, and you rightly pointed out, we were anyways underperforming for a long time. Indian markets in both equities, fixed income, real estate, we were behind the curve anyways, and a lot to do with the local factors. So we were anyways in the midst of what I call a credit bear market. And there was impact on credit portfolios or the fixed income portfolios, which had credit components in the client portfolio. So there was anyways a little bit of impact as far as fixed income was concerned. But what has happened over the last couple of months, and especially in a very short duration, has actually resulted in a little bit of a shock to client portfolios, not only in equities, but also in fixed income. I would also like to point out, a lot of our clients are investors in commercial real estate, directly and indirectly through REITs, for example. So they're also, they are facing a lot of headwinds, because in commercial real estate, there are ongoing discussions with the lease that they've given out for rent renegotiation. And a lot of projects are now stuck. So client portfolios have been impacted on all counts, be it equities, fixed income, and maybe alternatives, because right now they're locked in. So there was an element of shock earlier. I think the shock has been kind of digested. People have come to terms with the new reality. And now a lot of our clients actually are trying to do two things. One, what they're saying is, listen, I have taken a lot of damage on my mid-cap portfolio, even large caps. Is there an opportunity to shuffle my equity portfolios? That is number one. within equities, if I have the liquidity available, where should I add? But a lot of interesting conversations are happening on fixed income, Ajay. Actually, fixed income markets right now are very vibrant with opportunity, not as much with liquidity or as much with people who are trying to buy those ideas. But even on a AAA basis, there are huge opportunity available fixed income markets. The spreads are still elevated, even PSU, AAA or corporate bonds. And that is where we are seeing or we are advising clients to kind of look out for. So that is the sum and substance on fixed income. On real estate, it's a wait and watch. We are advising no action so far. We are just waiting and watching just to see where we go from here.
Right. Anshu, I'm on fixed income side, what kind of indicator yields are we talking about in an environment where rates are coming lower and yields are lower? The fixed income of say couple of years back, which could have yielded easily closer to 10% or 9% or thereabout, do you think next 5 year far out the fixed income range has also moved lower?
Right. So, and this is a very important point, Ajay. Thank you for bringing it out. And I really want to, through your show, talk to the investors out there that, listen, we are headed into a low inflation environment. The RBI action, whatever is happening, will bring down the yields in the market. So whatever may be available right now on a very high quality basis, please let's lock those yields in, and largely between 3 to 5 years. The yield impact is not as massive on the longer tenor, but in the shorter tenor, 3 to 5 year, pick up anything that is high quality. To give you an example, if you were to go to any good public sector bank that you feel very safe with and say, hey, I want to put a deposit, fixed deposit, you may maximum get up to 6% yield. But the bond of the same bank may be available to you between 8 to 9%. So there is a 200 to 300 basis point yield pickup available to you. Please evaluate that opportunity. Public sector bonds like PFC, REC are trading at anywhere between 7.75 to 8.50 or 9%, given on a daily basis. So do take advantage of that. If you are in the highest tax bracket, the tax-free still makes sense to you at 540, 550 yield. So each customer bases their tax rate, horizon, and liquidity. Please try and lock in yields now. The interest rates will fall. And that's a very important message all of us need to consider while building our fixed income portfolios. Fixed income is still the biggest asset class in our clients' portfolio. So let's be mindful. The last point is government is bringing down the small savings rate. So all of that is together going to put pressure downwards on fixed income. So let's please take advantage of any market dislocation that exists today.
Anshu, I'm also keen to ask you, the way premium real estate has been languishing for 5 years plus now, very low liquidity, hardly any deals, and the way environment has actually again gone kind of negative for premium real estate. Do you think people who really want to get in this space as well as a part and did not have much exposure here because of high valuations, they'll get ample opportunity in next 2 years?
I think there'll be a lot of opportunity, Ajay, but there's a word of caution. As far as commercial real estate is concerned, I think the way we work will change. And companies across the spectrum, across industries, will find a way to effectively cut their infra requirements, because we've all, as I said earlier, discovered this way, new way of working from home. And a lot of jobs could, a lot of infra creation that was expected on commercial real estate may come down by a factor. And therefore, I would not urge any immediate opportunity in commercial real estate. As far as residential is concerned, I think there's a lot more pain that may come in. Yes, maybe the affordable segment may come back very quickly, but in all the other segments, one revival of stuck projects. So that is something that needs to be considered. And two, wherever constructed property is available, unless there is a markdown, significant markdown from the values, I would advise against, you know, trying to take those contrarian bets. So that's the advice we have. Even, you know, if you see the listed REIT that is available, there is fair amount of correction in the price, but to certain extent that reflects the point that I was earlier making, that a new way of working may impact the overall demand for such projects. So I would urge investors to wait and just see how the clear picture emerges before they dip into real estate. Actually, on the other hand, maybe listed equity markets will give you a lot more opportunity to make as much or more with liquidity available to you. So just keep that liquidity factor also in mind when you look at something like real estate.
All right, Anshu, we'll let you go on that one. Thank you so much for help us analyze the asset allocation. What kind of outlook do each of these asset classes have? Because you guys do work with one of the biggest clients in the industry. Time for a very short break.